I rely on my experience and expertise and things that sort of inspire me. And then I put my own twist on it. You can really glean a lot of inspiration from everywhere around you if you just know where to look.
Recently, hosts Angie and Julie traveled to Paducah, Kentucky to welcome Shades host Ken Gray to the Spiel. Along the tree-lined promenades of Jefferson Street sits Gray Manor, the home of Ken and Kendra Gray. Much has been written about Gray Manor and the talent and design sense of Ken Gray, but a private tour from the designer himself, also known as the official Duke of Paducah, reveals a marriage of style and comfort that mere words cannot encapsulate.
Gray Manor was built in 1901. As a historic home, it was very important to me to retain a lot of the architectural elements, but just as, or more important, that I make it a home that my family is comfortable in and that inspires us. When I'm working with a client, reinvigorating a space, I wouldn't say I had a particular style, because it's my job to give the client their style, you know, and many times they don't know what that is, so I rely on my experience and expertise and things that sort of inspire me with them as people, with their current situation in their home, and then I put my own twist on it. I articulate this all the time. When I'm working with a client, I love to get to know them a little as much as I can, because I'm not going to be living in their house. They are.
But what about the house where Ken does live?
When I first walked into the home, I had an immediate vision of how it should look, how it should feel, what types of pieces should be in there, what walls needed to move. And we moved into the home in September. It was a real quick remodel. I love when my vision is executed and it actually ends up working out that way, which it does most of the time.
Another room where Ken's vision has come to life is the family dining room. A stunning treatment of 944 3-inch round mirrors create a shimmering backdrop to a stately dining room table, flanked on both sides by a matching pair of settees. Despite its overly formal look, the room serves as a functioning dining room for the family. Upstairs, just off from a warm and inviting master bedroom, lies a haven for style and the stylish. Even the closets are spectacular at Gray Manor, featuring a chandelier as a crowning centerpiece to a dressing room designed to invite and accommodate a large his and her wardrobe. And when you're not dressing up to step out, outside a formal garden area provides a relaxing escape, reminiscent of the garden retreats of old Charleston.
I love what I do. I guess the best part about what I do is getting to see the clients' faces when it's all done and know that they're gonna enjoy so much the spaces now, the new spaces, the fresh spaces. I'm inspired by so many things. I'm inspired by nature a lot. I'm inspired a lot by fashion. I love the use of all types of different fabrics in upholstery and window treatments. Wallpaper was so huge in the 80s, and then it sort of went out of fashion. Now it's back in a big way. I love the textured papers. So I love an organic approach to design. You can really glean a lot of inspiration from everywhere around you if you just know where to look. I love working on a project from the house plans up. A new home build is probably my favorite, because I get to sort of have input all the way through from the time the studs go up. Even before that, we're looking at the plans, you know, and I'm helping figure out silly things like this wall might need to be moved 2 or 3 inches this way to accommodate what will become furniture placement. Electrical outlets. It's important to have a designer to help you navigate through those types of decisions if you're building a home. It's an interesting tidbit. I have a shoe, tie, and sock fetish. My socks and my ties will always match. Growing up in a small town in Mississippi, it's very important to me to step outside my own box and move to a big city. So I lived in LA and Boston and New York and Atlanta and Paris, modeled for 18, 20 years, all the while having career in design. One of the best experiences is I hosted another TV show called Travel Spies, which was on the Travel Channel. So I got to travel everywhere, all over the place, reviewing hotel properties. There's nothing that will give you an inside scoop on hotels like being a travel spy. My whole adult career has, I've owned my own businesses. I owned the largest art gallery in Boston. I owned an award-winning interior design firm. And so this is the first time that I have worked for a company, and I cannot imagine working for a better company than Ethan Allen. Me as the designer or you as the client don't have to run all over creation looking for things for your home. We have it all in one place and everything is so customizable. You know, I've done so many homes and none of them look the same. I love the idea that it doesn't matter who you are, you can go and be and do whatever you want. It couldn't be easier with Ethan Allen's complimentary interior design service. You get me for free.
So tune in next time when we spiel another shade of Ken Gray.
Fresh faces, fresh spaces. I rely on my experience and expertise and things that sort of inspire me. And then I put my own twist on it. You can really glean a lot of inspiration from everywhere around you if you just know where to look.